Domino's Pizza used to have a very bad reputation for pizza that tastes like cardboard. But over the last 10 years, they have been one of the fastest growing companies in the world, going from single digit stock values to stock valued over $300. So how was Domino's able to make the transition from terrible pizza to being one of the largest restaurants in the world? Make sure to stick around till the end to find out. Welcome to Hari's Hobbies. So I'm going to be going over the top 5 reasons that Domino's was able to make such a great turnaround. But first, here's some quick history. Tom Monaghan and his brother James bought a local pizzeria named Dominic's in 1960. They paid a down payment of $500 and took a loan of $900. At first, it was agreed that they would do equal amounts of work, but James refused to quit his full-time job as a postman. As a result, 8 months after they acquired the store, James gave up his half of the company in return for a Volkswagen Beetle that they used for pizza deliveries. Tom continued with his venture, and by 1965, he bought 2 more pizzerias in the same county. But the problem was, the original owner didn't want Tom to use the name Dominic's for the new pizzerias. An employee named Jim Kennedy suggested a name Domino's, and Tom really liked it. And the 3 dots on the Domino's sign today represent the 3 original stores. Tom actually wanted to add a dot every single time they added a new store, but the franchise grew so rapidly that it just didn't make sense to do so. Speaking of franchises, the first franchise location was opened in 1967, and by 1978, they had a total of 200 locations in the United States. The first international store was opened up in Winnipeg, Canada on May 12, 1983. In this same year, they also reached 1,000 stores. But this was just a small achievement for them, as they would grow to add thousands of stores every single year. For example, they added 954 stores just 2 years later in 1985. They were the fastest growing pizza company, and they opened up their first restaurant in Asia in Japan in 1988. And soon enough, they also moved over to South America, where they opened a store in Colombia. But as they were expanding stores, they needed to expand their menus as well. In 1989, they added pan pizza, and in 1992, they added breadsticks, which is the first national non-pizza item. And in 1993, they added thin crust, and in 1994, they added buffalo wings. In 1996, they launched a website, Domino's.com, and offered flavored crusts for a limited time only. Just 2 years later in 1998, after 38 years of owning the store, Tom Monaghan was satisfied with his work and retired from the company. He sold 93% of the company to Bain Capital and ceased to be involved in day-to-day operations, and the new CEO, Dave Brandon, was appointed the next year. And in 2004, Dave took the company public, and his stock would actually rise pretty consistently due to new stores being added rapidly. But eventually, their bad-tasting pizza would take a toll on them, and from 2006 to 2008 was their worst years when their stock prices absolutely plummeted. Their stock prices were in the single digits and the company was going through a rapid decline, but then somehow they were able to turn around. And this was possible because they started off by reinventing their pizza. They had a terrible reputation for cardboard pizza and ketchup-y sauce. Most people would actually rather microwave pizza than order from Domino's. This would really hurt the stock of the company, but Patrick Doyle would come in as a new CEO in 2010 and completely change the trajectory of the company. Patrick Doyle knew that there was a problem, and reformulation of the pizza had started right before he came in late 2009. And since then, he's changed most of the pizza, adding handmade pan pizza and specialty chicken. He would also employ focus groups who would taste test the pizza. Employees would write down the comments and make changes based on the criticism. They also added new photos of the food that actually accurately represented the food. They took photos of food that employees actually made. It was no longer stylized, beautiful food shots taken by professionals. And this transition was essential for the company, as having a good core product is essential to any business. But changes to a product are useless unless the public actually know about it. So this is actually accompanied by a great marketing campaign. Patrick Doyle directly addressed concerns, admitting that their pizza tasted like cardboard and that you'd be better off microwaving frozen pizza. He encouraged that disappointed customers try their new recipe. They had several commercials in which customers would harshly criticize the pizza, and chefs would develop new pizza right next to them. And in 2011, they installed a huge billboard in New York's Times Square. This billboard displayed real-time comments from real customers, no matter how good or bad it was. They were very transparent that they had a bad product and they were trying very hard to improve it. And this transparency really gained the trust of the public, and the public realized that Domino's was making genuine efforts to try to improve their pizza. They also offered cheaper pizza with ads heavily focused on the price of $5 to $7. This reduced profit margins, but they were able to attain a much higher volume of sales. And this established Domino's as the cheap and convenient way to get pizza. At this point, they had developed a new product that people actually knew about. Domino's is also heavily invested in technology. The CEO has said on several occasions that they are as much of a technology company as they are a pizza company. They were a huge promoter of digital ordering, and they were very dedicated to make it easy and convenient. They were also very quick to jump onto the mobile platform as soon as smartphones started to become popular. And today, online ordering covers about 50% of all revenue for Domino's, and as a result, it was a very good thing that they invested in all of this technology. Their biggest competitor, Pizza Hut, is still struggling in the mobile space. Just recently, at the end of 2018, they acquired Quick Order in an effort to enhance their ordering experience. They also introduced Domino's Tracker, which is a pizza tracker that customers could use to track their pizza from the oven to their doorstep. Just recently, they launched a new rewards program and introduced Pulse. Pulse is a new point-of-sale system that is used in all domestic stores and 60% of all international stores. They are even implementing artificial intelligence with their Domino's Pizza Checker. This is a smart scanning device that hangs above the cut bench. It uses AI and machine learning in order to assess the quality of a pizza before it is sliced and boxed up. It compares the quality to existing pizzas, makes sure it's the right kind of pizza, and sees if the toppings are evenly distributed. If the pizza fails the test, the team will have to remake the pizza. Right now, they're focused on improving the capacity of their cars, working on self-driving cars, and even drone deliveries. All of this technology has allowed Domino's to deliver better pizza faster. They also really focused on international growth. From 2012 to 2016, they added 3,000 new locations internationally. The vast majority of these were overseas, as quick service pizza was a slow-growing market domestically. They saw vast international opportunities as the pizza delivery market was very underdeveloped internationally. There was a lack of strong competition, so Domino's would easily be able to develop a strong presence. And that's exactly what they did in the United Kingdom, India, and Mexico, where they opened 500 stores in each of those countries. But they did have problems with delivering within 30 minutes internationally, especially in China with heavy traffic congestion. As a result, they soon stopped the 30-minute guarantee. And they were still not done with their international growth. They actually have very ambitious goals moving forward. At the start of 2019, they had 15,300 stores in total, but by 2025, they want to add 9,700 more locations. That's nearly double the growth rate of the last 6 years, in which they only added 5,260 stores. And by 2025, they want to have $25 billion in annual sales globally. And in 2017, they only had half of that at $12.5 billion in sales globally. But they were very confident that the international market will get them there and that they can eventually dominate the pizza market worldwide. And of course, any great company that wishes to succeed long term needs to have great customer service. Domino's was able to create a great loyal fan base through their awesome service. Staff actually have an account on which they take notes on the customer. They write down things like if you had an absurd order, or if your delivery was late, or if they messed up your delivery. And in most cases, they will give you a free pizza next time if it truly is their fault. They were also very serious on their promises and took many measures in order to ensure that they fulfilled them. They take several steps in order to make sure that gluten-free and vegan pizza actually are gluten-free and vegan pizza. From individually sealing these bases in order to avoid confusion, to making these bases a different size and making a fresh batch of sauce to go along with them. As you can see, they are very serious on their promises, just as any restaurant really should be. And this has really enabled them to grow a great customer base, which is essential in the restaurant industry. Domino's has been in the pizza industry for a long time, but even today, many people have a bad impression on Domino's due to one bad experience several years ago. Many of them don't realize how much the company has changed since then. Domino's has made a remarkable turnaround that has never been seen before, not just in the pizza industry, but in the restaurant industry as a whole. It truly is very impressive. And all of you guys who haven't tried Domino's in a long time, I encourage you to give them another shot because they truly are a different company today. But that's all I have for you guys on Domino's. Make sure to comment down below what company you would like me to cover next. Also, if you guys liked this video, then make sure to drop a like and consider subscribing if you would like to see more videos just like this one. But until then, I'm Hari, I'll see you guys on the next one.